here we are in part two, beginning our redecoration process. I know this looks like madness, though I'm just spraying paint everywhere like a crazy man, but there's a method to this madness. Just a reminder, this is going to be a B level repair.
Okay, so I'm going to wipe off some of this. This is quicker and easier than masking. I have a little bit of alcohol on this pt2.
So we're going to start with the background colors.
So now I'm going to scrape off the paint on these lines like I was telling you. And this is just, it's a bit tedious, but it beats trying to mask this or try to paint it. And I may still have to paint some of it, but this will take. So as you can see all around me, there are, you can still see the cracks, and some of this will get filled as I go, as like we've seen a moment ago about the many coats of cold glaze. It's going to take to cover all this stuff. Some of this will get filled, buried, or hidden in layers of cold glaze. It will fill that as I fill in sand and fill in sand. And in some of these places, like here, there are little pits and spaces that we couldn't see until we get this paint on. And that's a common thing. But I have ways to fill that and without starting over from scratch. But anyway, there is a massive amount of work on this thing. It's just very, very tedious and very slow, very laborious. And there's no way to speed this up. You just have to go and be patient and work at it a little bit at a time. And sooner or later, it will be done. So I've got a lot of rubbing to do to get through these before I can put some cold glaze on this.
And now some of the lighter background colors.
Okay, so I'm doing another color now. It's a background color. We have this light brown here, and it's under a lot of this. This whole area with the black, this brown is underneath it, and where it shows through in a lot of places. So I'm, rather than do a lot of masking and, you know, card holding to mask with my airbrush, I'm going to hand paint a lot of this because it just, you know, just islands of color here, and it just saves me a lot of work. So I'm going to do a little hand painting. And I might go over some of these other areas where there are larger portions with an airbrush.
It'll take more than one coat to cover with this color, and I'll be drying with a hair dryer between coats.
So I'm going to rub off some of these high spots on these stripes. reason I'm painting this with a brush is because this, let's see if I can find a spot on here where you can see it. It's hard to see, but there you can see the brush strokes in this. It's rather haphazard, it's not neat, and you can see through it in certain places. It's not quite the same density everywhere, so it looks like it's been slopped on there. That's part of the look. And so I'm using a mop type round brush to get something like that look. So if you've noticed, this brown under here is under this whole area, and then they put these yellow stripes on here, and then went through and painted all this, skipping that area where the stripes was, and then came back over top of that when you were done and put the yellow dots in it. But I want to get that same look with the washy, paintbrushy strokes in here, and so that's why I'm doing what I'm doing. And then in some places I need to do two coats to cover it, because you can see through it, like right here. So I just go back over where it's needed and deal with it accordingly. So some pieces missing through here, so I have to see past what I'm doing and see the design that's going to come in behind it. So this orange is going to go down through here, and this part of this costume is going to be painted in. So I'm just looking at the background that I need to paint in for now. It's hard to get good coverage with this yellow, so I'm gonna dry this again and repeated coats until I cover it. Wiping off these high points on this scroll work. Come back and do another coat on that in a few minutes. So I need to come back and do a slightly different color of this orange on here, and so we'll get some coverage up here on this peak. And I need to paint this brown background back in here. And I need to touch up this orange in here again. But there's no point in filming it and making you watch me painting the same area over and over again until it's covered. That's what we're gonna do. Paint it until you can't see through it anymore. All right, so now I'm gonna put the background color behind here, where you see these white going through this brown, medium brown behind here. So I'm gonna chase down all these white lines going through this kind of thing. That's what we're doing today. Alright, so today we're doing the terracotta, or red oxide color here. So I'm going to go back over and rub off the paint on some of these high points, these little dots. It's just easier to paint over them and scrape it off than it is to mask them or try to paint around them. So I'm going to be coming back and putting a lot of detail in here, and those will be in the final stages. Basically, I'm getting all the colors that have no texture to them, working my way out from the background. And as I go, we'll be painting smaller and smaller areas. And very soon, I'll be getting to this dimensional stuff that's on top of all these things. It's more and more detail. But we've still got a couple more areas. We got to do the blue here, and I'm not sure what else yet, but that might be all there is. Right now I'm going to bring in these streaks here. Okay, so today I need to go and add this a dirty wash to some of the areas that I just painted in, and it looks like this. This is in the glaze. It's not grime on top of everything. It's part of the original look. So it softens things and gives it an antique look. So I need to duplicate this sort of dirty wash in these areas where I just painted in the last couple sessions. It looks a little too bright and clean. And in here too. So that's what we're doing today. So I've mixed up a grimy looking wash with a lot of transparency in it. And I'm just gonna swoosh it in here. Dry that so I can turn it. I'm bringing some green on these leaves. So here's a quick view of the leaves I just painted. Some on this side, some over here. I'll have to go over some of this because the lines inside these are obliterated, so I'll repaint them. But that's it for today. All right. So it's the next day and we're doing another color, and it's going to be this dark maroon. So I'm starting to do some of this dimensional painting where it's a raised welt of paint and I need a thicker stuff. So I'm using this, it's a solvent-based acrylic. It's almost like nail polish. It's very thick, it's very shiny, glossy acrylic. It looks like lacquer paint, but it's an acrylic formulation. And I don't even think Silmasta, who made this, I don't think they make it anymore. I've just had, this paint's over 10 years old. I've had it for a long time. So I'm using it because it hopefully will give me some of that dimensionality that I need. It's a very thick paint. So that's what I'm using. I need this green color here, which is lighter than this. And I mixed a little yellow in it, made it a yellow green. And we'll apply some now. So right in here is where there were some missing pieces. It's flat and there's no dimensionality left to it. I'm trying to build this up a bit, put a little welt into this. So now I need to mask off the gold so I can spray paint it so I don't get brush strokes in it and all that jazz. So I'm using this stuff. I use this often. You just never see me apply it. It's, you know, any brand will do. It's a liquid frisket, mostly used by watercolor artists, but, you know, some airbrush artists use it too. But anyway, you want a liquid frisket mask. It's a latex-based thing, and it's basically latex in ammonia. And this will dry clear, or clear-ish. It's sort of amber, but you won't be able to see it once it dries on here. But I have to go out a ways because I can't wipe off the gold overspray. It's a solvent-based paint, and it will take off the paint and the cold glaze under it if I try that. So I gotta give myself ample room around where I'm gonna be spraying. So I need to do that in every area where I have gold paint, and then we'll have masked it off so we can spray gold. I'm not going to make you watch me do all of it. You get the idea. So now I just want to rub off this brisket. Okay, so now we're getting into the more and more detailed painting, where I'm really just painting very tiny little things. Like today I'm doing these green dots. So as I go through this process, I'm not going to film every little tiny speck of paint I'm putting on. But that's what I will be doing at this point. And some places there will be literally just a touch of paint and we're done with that color. But as I go, I'll be just touching up very tiny details, as you see I'm doing here. Okay, so we're finally getting into the final stages of this repair. And now I'm done all with all my decorating and stuff. And so this everything I did has a sealer over it so that it protects the paint from getting messed up when I'm working on some other part of it. And I don't want to rub the paint off. So if I'm working over here, I don't want it getting rubbed off on the other side when I'm working on my pads. So so now I need to go in, and parts of this are going to be glossy, like these mountains and the gold and some of these kinds of things. They're very glossy, but some of the background colors, like this brown down here and the black, these darker areas, those are have a matte finish. So I'm going to apply a matte finish to those areas as my final stage. So that's what we're going to do today. And I'll be hand applying that with a paintbrush. And I'm using this stuff, porcelain restoration glaze. This is the matte version.